Hi, I'm Tamara and I have a problem. I'm clearly addicted to Gucci shoes. Hello my lovelies! Today I hope all is Gucci because we are going to be talking about my Gucci collections because I just brought everything that I own from this Italian brand in order to show you. So let's get straight into it. To start off, I was thinking, what should I wear while filming this video? And I opted for my currently favorite Gucci t-shirt. It's just an off-white simple t-shirt which says Gucci. Not very original, and I normally don't really like t-shirts that say like Gucci, because all of my other Gucci t-shirts, which you will see later, are not like this. But I don't know why, for some reason I love this one so much, and it probably looks a bit tatty because I've been wearing it all day today, so sus. In order to film this video, as always, I compiled everything on my bed and I kind of realized one major thing, that there's no more shoes left in my wardrobe, in my shoe closet, because they're all here, since it turned out that I own 13 pairs of Gucci shoes, and that's because I got rid of some. Hi, I'm Tamara and I have a problem. I'm clearly addicted to Gucci shoes. I think that's probably my favorite thing from this brand, shoes, so I decided to start with them. We can all probably agree that in between Tom Ford and Alessandro Michelle, no one even entered a Gucci store or even looked at its window, because Gucci was just something that I personally stayed away from. Like, I don't know, it was just very boring for me until Alessandro Michele arrived. I mean, there were a few Frida Giannini kind of moves that I was like, okay, this is cool, like the color block movement in 2010. 2010 was kind of a cool year for Gucci, I think. But it was all like the last kind of, you know, like the big platform, golden sandals and so on. Since Alessandro Michele came, I acquired a huge Gucci collection, and I've started with shoes and bags, went to ready to wear, and of course in the meanwhile got a belt because I just had to join a basic club. Sorry, can I swear? Yeah, so I started with like a super basic piece, which is the Gucci belt that I think everybody has. Like, if you have an Instagram, you probably have a Gucci belt as well. Actually, I had like some old logo ones as well that I don't have anymore because I think I got rid of them, but this is all that I have and wear in my wardrobe. So I'll show you my favorite bag that I have from Gucci, which is this medium Dionysus bag in kind of like a beautiful velvet logo print, and with a dragon which is crystallized a little bit, but it's very cool. I think it's kind of rock and rolly, silver chain as usual, and this is the middle size as mentioned. It opens like this, and inside it's blue satin. I actually really like this bag, and I had the Dionysus also like the big size in like a super neutral one. I'll try and insert a picture of one of my outfits. I think I'm selling that bag because it's not on my shelf anymore. Like, we're selling it and donating income to the charity. That's what we do with the stuff that I don't wear anymore. And I also had a micro one which I already sold because I never wore it. Now this is the Dionysus I have, and I love it so much. I think it's really beautiful, it's very unique and special. I also had a top handle, like a bamboo Dionysus bag, which got stolen when we got robbed in Saint-Tropez. Is it 3 or 4 years ago now? But yeah, we got robbed and they stole that bag, and I never replaced it because I was like, okay, clearly it was not meant to be for me, right? So yeah, that's my current favorite Gucci bag that I own. To move on, I think I'm gonna talk to you about the first pair of Gucci shoes that I got from Alessandro Michele's kind of rain. They're kind of ruined, I have to say. Yeah. They are these like sort of mules, I don't know if you can tell. They're like mules which have many belts in front. This is what they look like. And they have like buttons with Gucci logo on the side. I think they're very flattering when worn. I haven't worn them maybe in 2 years, but I'm still keeping them because I like them. And I think, you know, they were the first kind of like Alessandro Michele Gucci shoes that I got. After them, I got into Princetown Marmont first. Then it just kept going on and on and on. I got also 2 pairs of sneakers. So I got these red, blue, white striped ones on the side, pearls all around, and these are in size 38, even though I'm normally a 39, 40 in size, but in Gucci shoes I always size down when it comes to sneakers, so, because I will link everything below, you guys know, in case you want to buy any of these. I wore these quite a fair amount of times. I really like them. I bought them in person in Selfridges. Same goes for these. I remember seeing them, my friend Nina had them at the time, and I was like, wow, these are so beautiful. So they're like plain on one side and they have all of this embroidery on the other side. I remember seeing them on my friend Nina and thinking, wow, these are so beautiful, I need them. So I went in store and tried them on and bought them, and these were actually first pair of trainers that I bought, which was only like 2 or 3 years ago. And now I have around 10 pairs of trainers, which still, like, I guess for a lot of people isn't a lot, but, like, you know what I mean, for me is a lot considering that I never wore trainers up until 3 years ago. So how and why I got into Gucci ready to wear? I really, really loved their sweaters. That was like the first thing that I fell in love with, and it was this colorful one that I just thought is so beautiful, and it says loved. I love the whole movement with like loved everywhere, also blind for love, kind of makes sense. But I love this because it's like a beautiful colorful cashmere sweater with this tiger, which many people might think is a bit excessive, but I still to this day wear this sweater. I love it, I love styling it. It's so easy and so fun to style because of the beautiful colors, and actually because it's kind of thin, I still wear it even during the winter if I layer it, or spring, summer months. So yay for Gucci. Fun fact, actually, I also met Alessandro Michelle at British Fashion Awards 2017. He won an award and I was wearing Gucci shoes, and afterwards at the party he complimented my shoes. And I was wearing a pretty rare pair of shoes, which are like a runway shoes that are so expensive. They were so expensive, but I bought them because the same summer that we got robbed, like, kind of wanted to treat myself with something after it all happened, and I bought these in Cannes. After actually one of my Jimmy Choo's got ruined and I didn't really have anything to wear, I went to Gucci and bought these in Cannes. I love them, like, they're kind of pink gold, they have the tiger in front, and they are very, very, I think they are very, very sexy and beautiful when worn on. I wish I wore them more. I haven't worn them that much. I do think this like pink metallic gold is a little bit difficult to style, but I will give my best this summer to wear them a little bit more, because yes, they were expensive, and yes, I want to wear them more. Another bag from Gucci that I have would be this little Marmont wallet on a chain. I don't really wear this bag that much anymore. I have worn it so much because inside it's like a harmonica, as you can see. At the back there it has many, many card slots. Then it has like a kind of pocket here which is zippable, and then more card slots. I think this is amazing. I remember once, like 3 or 4 years ago when I got it, I worn it a lot in Milan. I had like a set of meetings and this fit like my sunglasses, external battery charger, cards, and the phone, everything I needed for a whole day of like events and meetings. And I wore these with these Gucci shoes and I thought I was so cool, because these Gucci shoes, I get so many compliments on. They have like pearls at the back like the sneakers do. They, I guess, like, they're your typical grandma shoe, you know, like something that people would love to hate, but I think these two together are just so cool. Probably all of our boyfriends of the world, if they would unite, they would ban these shoes. They would think they're horrible, they're Superman repelling, they're ultimate grandma shoe, but very fashion and very cool. And I loved wearing these for meetings around Milan. I haven't worn them in a while though now. I think I should change that because I still think they're very, very cool. It's just that they're so in your face that when you work in fashion, like I do, when you wear something this few seasons ago, it can get a little bit like, kind of old. Besides this bag, funnily enough, and this bag, I don't really think I have any other Gucci bags in my collection. So that would be it. Let's talk about small things. Sunglasses. Now, I don't even have that many Gucci sunglasses. I think obviously shoes are going to be predominant in this video, but I love these. I don't really remember when I got these, but I have them and I love them. They have like the kind of typical Gucci green and red stripes on the side and some symbols, and they are my kind of beloved big Gucci sunglasses. Then almost a year ago, I got these at the airport. Well, I know actually when. I got them in October when I was flying to Serbia. So I got these at the airport. I think they're very cool, like kind of for a nerdy look. I don't actually wear glasses on a daily basis, but I think these were very, very fashion. And then this summer in August, I also got these on flannels. I wore them a lot. I'll also insert the picture. I wore them a lot when I went to Croatia this summer, especially with this Gucci headband. I thought it was like such a cool mix. Probably not the best idea to do this without a mirror, right? But something like this, when you have like beach hair, this is very difficult to do without a mirror. But kind of try and imagine it, something like this. Now I just look like I have issues, right? Like I've broken my neck or something like that. But ouch, why did I do this to myself? Anyway, these sunglasses and this headband, love this floral print, like Gucci and flowers. This is like probably my favorite print that they have done. A pair of shoes that I'm very emotionally attached to are these queer, what are they called? I forgot, but they're very, very crazy. They were very expensive as well. But I actually got these as a birthday present for my sister. They're so dusty. I haven't worn them for a while and I want to change that ASAP. I think this is probably one of the coolest heels I have ever seen in my life. And I just love these because they're such a statement piece. I mean, I wore them a few times, but I wish I wore them more because I think they're just so spectacular. I got these for my sister for my 28th birthday. I'll never forget, actually, we went to Gucci Boutique on Bond Street. I kind of had a crappy day, like start of the birthday. We just had such a nice breakfast and the day we went to Gucci. Also the Gucci stuff on Bond Street, they're so lovely. Like I love the whole entire team. They wrote me like a nice card. I just really like, I don't know, I love that boutique, it's my favorite. So yeah, we got these shoes. I wish I wore them more because I love them. I think they're very, very, very cool. When it comes to ready to wear, besides the t-shirts, the most worn item that I have, okay, it's not so easy as I thought. I think the most worn item that I have would be this spectacular jacket. It says modern and that's it. This is what it looks like. It's a denim jacket with a shirling and at the back it has this embroidery. I absolutely love this piece. It's like a museum piece. It's so stunning. It's so cozy. It's something that I love wearing, and if I can find a picture, I would love to insert it. Okay, so I love traveling in this because when you put it on, it's like you're in a duvet, in a way. And I actually wear this with a Gucci hoodie as well underneath. Sadly, my sister kindly borrowed the hoodie, and I cannot find it in her wardrobe, so I cannot show it to you. But I have a black hoodie, which just says Gucci in front, and I love wearing it with this, and I love traveling in it because it's so cozy. So yeah, this is like one of my absolute favorite Gucci pieces and most worn for sure. Also, okay, like lately I've also worn this skirt so much, and it's on a Marks & Spencer's hanger because I love M&S. Who wouldn't? But anyway, like, this skirt I've worn so much lately. Again, I'll insert pictures, videos, whatever I have of me in this skirt because I kind of like don't really take it off that much. I wear it with trainers, with heels, with over-the-knee boots, with ankle boots, like my white Dior sneakers, like anything. And I honestly love this skirt so much. Every time I wear it, I get so many compliments. Now, let's break it off with some shoes. Two kind of similar pairs you have seen recently. I've got the Bow Gucci Holiday Collection Golden High Heels, but probably most worn heels and my favorite heels of all of my shoes would be these. Okay. These are like double service. They're like two kind of shoes, like simple sandals like this, or you wear them with this bow. And these are just what you see. These are my kind of gold bow shoes. These are my silver bow shoes. And honestly, these shoes are my most worn high heels and the shoes that, oh my God, I've almost reached the point where you need to change the tip. But I was just gonna say, so I've been wearing these for like more than a year now, and I honestly, they haven't lost a single crystal, and you like, I do not need to change the tip. Okay, I will be changing the tip soon, but these are my favorite heels. I love them so much. I would buy them again if I would see them in my size, which is 40. If you find them anywhere, let me know, because I would like to repurchase them because I love them so much. I love these two, but I feel like the other ones are more like multi-purpose, so they're just incredible and one of my favorite pairs of shoes. Now, Gucci is really great with the accessories, as you guys know, which is why I also acquired over the time a lot of socks from Gucci. Now, I have these tights that are just perfection. I wear them a lot. I recently wore them as well in Genoa. I wore them in March, like with actually the Gucci bow heel and like just like a blazer dress. I wear them a lot. I think they're very cool and very enduring. I just put them in a washing machine and wash them and I don't have any issues with them. I have another pair of Gucci tights, which are these white ones. I've never actually worn these out, so yet to kind of bring them in, but this is what they look like. I'll insert a picture because I do have a few pictures of me out in front of the mirror when I try them on. And then I have three pairs of just socks. These I mainly purchase when I have like a store credit or something like that, and then I have like £100 left because that's what they cost, or 80, I don't know, 100 euro left. But you know, if you don't spend it, then you lose it, so this is what I buy. And actually they're very cool, especially been wearing these a lot in my boots, and then I kind of laid them down. And the pink ones I love as well, also wore them. The green ones, they look fun, but I just never really got to wear them. It was a good idea, but not great realization, like, you know, not great kind of delivery on my side. This belt here, I bought in Milan, also when I went for meetings. It was just when I signed with my current agency, so quite a few years ago now, like 2 or 3 years ago now. Why is my arm look so dirty right here? I think it's just a shadow. Now when I think about that trip, I'm so happy because like my agency, like my whole management and my whole team are like my best friends. They are actually my best friends and I love them so much and I just enjoy their company so much. And that trip was like the first time that I went to Milan to do the meetings after I signed with that agency, and I just love them so much. It gives me such good memories. Anyway, I bought this belt as a souvenir, and also the pearl sneakers that you could see at the beginning. I wear this over the coats, over dresses, over blazers, over everything. It was very, very cool. I wore this last New Year's Eve as well during the day parties. Like, I really love it, but right now I'm a little bit like, ooh, it's like a huge logo in your face. I don't know. What do you guys think? I remember that when I got it, everyone was searching for it and it was sold out everywhere. Now they do it with a total pearl buckle as well. Now, another like a floral Gucci theme here. You guys know I love this, like I said. This is so cool because you can wear it like in your hair, well, in a way, like this, or all around your head. You know, like you just put on a scarf like this, which I think is so cute. I love, like, love this scarf. I actually got this one from my friend Camilla for my birthday as a present, so very, very nice. I wore it a lot already, even wore it on a TV show for an appearance, so yeah. A dress that I remember I wore once in Mykonos, and then my friend Enrico told me, you can never get rid of this dress. This dress is forever. It's for your daughters, it's for your granddaughters, it's for your children. You need this dress forever in your life. And I love this dress. It's very like, it feels a little bit like my mom in the 90s, because this is the kind of prints that my, like, kind of print my mom used to wear in 90s. But anyway, it's a beautiful silk dress, pure silk, beautiful print. I love wearing it and I think it's very, very special piece in my wardrobe. T-shirts, guys. I love a good t-shirt, and I have to say Gucci is definitely guilty of making pretty good t-shirts. Now we have this red one which says Gucci-fy yourself, and then there's like a Roman 25 here as well, white and red. Love it. Besides the one that I'm wearing, which just says Gucci and a lot of cities underneath, like Florence, Roma, Paris, London, Berlin, Madrid, Athens, Prague, New York, Beverly Hills, Chicago, San Francisco, Sao Paulo, Moscow, Dubai, Hong Kong, Beijing, Shanghai, Tokyo, Seoul, Novi Sad. Just kidding, Novi Sad's not on the list, but it's my hometown, so anyway, we got this Gucci Chateau Marmont Hollywood t-shirt, which is the most recent one in my collection, but the back is what makes it so special. I love the like herbarium vibes. Do you guys know what the herbarium is? First knit that I bought from Gucci was this stripy one, and I bought it I think when I was going to mountains. I love the like buttons that it has around the collar, the like pearl and the logo. They're so pretty, and I think this is quite a, like a mountain chic knit. I wore it quite a bit and I love it. The golden thing around the collar and the bottom can be a little bit itchy, but I'm not one of those people that get itchy by knits, so I don't care. More shoes, because I first got gold Marmont Gucci shoes and then I replaced them. Well, I didn't replace them, I still had them and I wore them so much, and then I sold those. But I still have these red ones, and these are with a lower heel. These I haven't worn as much and possibly would like to sell as well. I'm not actually wearing them that much. They're a size 39 and yeah. And same goes for these loafers, also size 39, but at least I've worn these quite a bit. They're like a sort of lilac-y pink color. They're beautiful. I love them. I love how Gucci makes these, like the soft, beautiful leather, classic loafer. Love them so much that I also got them in open back version. The first ones that I got, I wanted them so much and ordered them on Gucci, and then when they arrived I remember being like such a happy girl. Look at how pretty they are inside, like inside of the shoe. They're like pink and beautiful, size 40, because I don't like open back shoes to be tight and snug, because I don't like my heel to poke. So I got them in this light pink nude version as well, and I'm honestly wearing these so much, especially summer, especially with all of my Zimmermann dresses. They're beautiful, kind of like nudey light pink color, and very very comfortable. Also with jeans, like I have so many outfits with these shoes. Let's quickly discuss a few more ready-to-wear pieces. Like these kind of like a Gucci monogram jogger pants. So these are just like tracksuits, like, you know, like a classic tracksuit. I wear this with a white t-shirt, denim jacket and sneakers when I'm traveling. And they're kind of like fashionable, but still quite comfortable to travel and fly in. Like if I'm gonna fly to Hawaii, this would be an ideal thing to fly in. Also, another pair of bottoms are these jeans. I need to open them in order to show you. They have a snake print and I love snakes. So I'm parcel tongue and I love snakes. Any Harry Potter fans? I love snakes. Snake is my horoscope sign, like Chinese horoscope. And I just had to get these jeans. I really need to kind of shorten them. They're too long. I would probably wear them a bit more if I would shorten them. But I love them. Love them so much. It's also one of the first pieces that I got from Gucci ready to wear. And one of the last pieces that I got from Gucci ready to wear. Or in fact, the last piece I got from Gucci ready to wear would be this pair of shorts. I will again link this below as well. I know they also come in pink, which is beautiful. And red. And yeah, I really love this so much that I'm even thinking of getting a blazer, like matching blazer. But would that be too much? Let me know what you think. In fact, the last piece that I have to show you would be a pair of Princeton fur slides. These are the like first series kind of these slides before they changed from fur to non-fur, I think. But these are size 39 and I do regret it a little bit because they're too snug and I should have gotten 40, but I still wore them quite a bit. I love how comfy they are still, especially if I wear them with like a thin sock. They're like slippers worn outside, so yeah. I think it's also great for Gucci for kind of changing and trying to be more ethical, which is what should be the ideal of the future. Anyway, that is it. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm sure I forgot some pieces, like the black hoodie that my sister conveniently took, and probably something else, but this is all that I could see as I was kind of getting stuff out. I love you guys. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you soon. Bye.